We'd like to try to use the integral test to determine if the sum k equals 5 to infinity of k over k squared minus 29 converges or diverges. First, we need to show that the hypotheses of the integral test are satisfied. So the first question is f of x equaling x over x squared minus 29 continuous? Well, the only place it might not be continuous is when the bottom is 0. So let's set x squared minus 29 equal to 0, squared equals 29, x equals the square root of 29, plus or minus, of course. So we have two places, points of discontinuity, but remember we just want this to eventually be continuous, positive, and decreasing. So it is eventually continuous. We'll have to define what eventually is when we're done checking all of the criteria here. So the next question is f of x equaling x over x squared minus 29 positive eventually? Well, we know where it's discontinuous, and so we also need to know where it equals 0. It equals 0 when k equals 0. That's where the top of the fraction equals 0. So we have a number line with negative square root of 29, 0, and square root of 29. And all we really care about is this last interval, because we want to know, is it eventually positive? So let's pick something bigger than the square root of 29, like 6, because I know 6 squared is 36, so that's bigger than 29. And let's plug that into our function. F of 6 would be 6 over 36 minus 29, so that's 6 over 7, so yes, that's positive. So it is eventually positive. And then the last thing to check is it's decreasing? So to check for decreasing, let's take the derivative. So f prime of x is going to be the derivative of the top, which is 1, times the bottom, x squared minus 29, minus the top times the derivative of the bottom, all over the bottom squared. And if we simplify that a little bit, we're going to get negative x squared minus 29 all over x squared minus 29 squared. So we know the bottom is squared, so it's always positive. And we know the top is a negative number minus another number, so that's also always going to be negative. So we always have a negative over a positive, so we always have this function decreasing. So then the next question is, we said that it was eventually positive and eventually continuous. So what do we mean by eventually? Well, in both cases, we need it to be bigger than the square root of 29. So we can just say 6 is bigger than the square root of 29. So let's say that f of x is continuous, positive, and decreasing on the interval of 6 to infinity. Therefore, we can use the integral test. So we want to look at the integral from 6 to infinity of f of x dx. It's going to be the limit as whatever your favorite letter is, how about t, goes to infinity, of the integral of 6 to t of our function, which is x over x squared minus 29. So now we need to do probably a u substitution. We're thinking about u equals x squared minus 29, du equals 2x dx. So we're finding the antiderivative of 1 half of 1 over u du, which means our answer is going to be 1 half the natural log of the absolute value of x squared minus 29. That's our antiderivative. So now we can go back to our problem here, and now that we know the antiderivative, we can stick that in. So we can say that we're looking at, this is our work over here to the side, we're looking at the limit as t goes to infinity of 1 half the natural log of the absolute value of x squared minus 29 evaluated from 6 to t. Plugging in gives us the limit as t goes to infinity of 1 half natural log of the absolute value of t squared minus 29 minus 1 half natural log of the absolute value of 6 squared minus 29. And now we notice that as t goes to infinity, t squared goes to infinity, so natural log of t squared is also going to go to infinity. So this is actually going to diverge. Now we have to write a conclusion though. We have shown that by the integral test, the sum starting at 6, sum going from 6 to infinity of k over k squared minus 29 diverges. But then, because we know if the tail diverges, the series diverges, the sum k starting at 5 to infinity of k over k squared minus 29 also diverges.